Hi, this is the G-Spot with Alana Gorelick for Wolf TV. I thought as a graduating senior, it's about time that I look back on my last 4 years at Michigan, specifically the Michigan football program. And I thought that I would have two experts talk to me about what they think were the highs and lows of the season so far. So I have with me Brad and Emily, who are going to talk about how they sum up the last four seasons and where they see some improvements. So Emily, you are a senior as well.
Yes.
So let's start with 2007, Lloyd Carr. What do you think would be the high and the low of that season of Michigan football?
The low, I gotta say that App State game. My first game coming in as a freshman, you know, I was told Michigan football, great program, one of the best. I come in, we lose to this team nobody's ever heard of. It was brutal.
But at least, you know, that year we did have a bowl win to Florida, which was pretty impressive.
That was a big deal. I think beating Tim Tebow in the Capital One Bowl that year really turned Lloyd Carr's season around and ended on a high note for sure.
Definitely. But then, of course, we transitioned to the Rich Rodriguez era, where he had a rough transition. Brad, what do you think in Rich Rod era of 2008, what do you think was the high and the low point?
Well, 2008 being my freshman year, Lloyd Carr really left the cupboard bare for Rich Rod, so he didn't have a lot to work with. Low point, we lost to a MAC school, and it was the first time we ever lost to a MAC school. The high point really was the Wisconsin game, 100th game in Michigan Stadium, and Michigan really came out. They beat a ranked opponent, so that was just the only bright spot in a terrible season for Michigan.
Yeah. Next is 2009 with a finish of 5-7, and we had a new quarterback, Tate Forcier. And I think, you know, a win for that era would be the Notre Dame game. What about, do you agree, Emily?
Definitely. I think the Notre Dame game was kind of the bright spot of that season. You know, Tate Forcier starting out 4-0, obviously the dramatic finish in that game.
Definitely. Well, moving on to the last era of 2010, this past season was the final year of Rich Rodriguez, and there's definitely been some highs and lows, and at least we finally made it to another bowl game under him. I definitely think one crazy entertaining game was the Illinois game. Three overtimes. I've never seen such a thing. What are your thoughts, Emily?
Oh, that game was awesome. I mean, just back and forth, back and forth. The fact that we won it in the student section, you know, the ball coming that way towards us, that was an awesome game. I mean, I think it pretty much sums up our season in terms of, you know, the defense, lacking in the defense, and the really high-octane offense. But, again, you know, an exciting game, an exciting win, but still not the best season once again.
Yeah. I mean, it was good we made it to a bowl game with Mississippi State Gator Bowl, but at the same time,
yeah,
38 points.
It wasn't good. The year started off good. I mean, they started off 5-0, and they were looking really, really good. You know, expecting bowl game, Rich Rod looks like he's going to keep his job. Then towards the end of the season, they lost to a couple good opponents, but to a couple bad opponents, mm-hmm. One being Penn State. So it really killed them. Just not enough improvement under Rich Rod, and that's the reason he's gone.
Looking back at these past four seasons, how would both of you sum it up?
I would say it was probably like an emotional roller coaster. You know, it was all over the place. Obviously, the first season, 2007, App State, that was tough in the beginning, but then ending with the win in the bowl game. And then, you know, going on, Tate Forcier starting 4-0, Denard Robinson starting 5-0. You know, that was exciting. And then obviously the end of the season was really frustrating and some really bad losses. So I feel like it was kind of all over the place, but all in all, you know, can't complain. Go to a school like Michigan, it's always exciting.
Yeah, I mean, it was really un-Michigan-like. One of the darkest eras in Michigan history. That's how they're going to look back on it. It was a failed experiment with the spread. That's not really what killed it, but that's how a lot of Michigan fans are going to look back on it.
Definitely, I agree with both of you. You know, the Rich Rod era was a good experiment to have somebody who's from the South, who's used to different players, a different system, but obviously it's time for someone new, and I look forward to see who that person will be, but you know, we just have had some great Michigan players and some that have made it to the NFL, so I think we have to be optimistic in this situation, and I think we're going to have a good coach and a good program in the future. It's just going to take some time, so thank you guys for joining me. I really do appreciate your comments, and great expert analysis. So this has been the G-Spot with Alana Gorelick for Wolf TV. Thanks for watching. Good night.